Of course. I forgot to hit the sound button. I'm so sorry. Oh, it's been one of those weeks. Hi, Dee. I hope you're doing well too. We're surviving. Anyways, I was saying that I'm going to complete this tree. I've got the wisteria because there's a little bit of purple here and there that I want to get into the actual tree. I have the black, I've got the white, I've got the warm gray 2, the warm gray 4, and the warm gray 6. I'm starting with the warm gray 6, at least at the top, to start sketching in some of these branches so we can start seeing where things are at. Otherwise, that's pretty much all that's happened. goodness. Goodness, goodness. I might have to come back with the black and really get some of these in. It's really some of these. Finer ones that I really want to get. Etched in there a little bit. And this is kind of why I'm glad I painted over this. Because some of those spidery branches I wouldn't have been able to get in otherwise. Start going pretty light with this because there's some areas where we start to get that highlighting. Okay. I'm going to zoom in for you guys. Scooch it just a little.
Okay. I'm actually going to start dark to light with this. Just because I think it'll be easier for my mental space to do it that way. Especially since I want to get some of that texture in there of the bark. Which is going to be slightly more important when we get to the trunk of the tree. I'm sorry if I'm not super talkative today. I will admit, I'm a little tired. We shall see. How today goes. trying to process how to do this in my brain. And I can't say I fully know how I want to do this. So this is going to look really sketchy for a little while. So I'm going back to the Warm Grace 6. Might have to pull... brownish color. To get even more of a brownish tone in this. I didn't quite see that last time. What do I want to pull? I think I might pull the tan. Get some tan laid down. That's the fun part of Kincaid is, I mean, he does such an interesting mix of colors. Don't really notice until you're in the middle of trying to actually replicate it. I'm sure it's mostly in these few little highlights. But it's also something that you don't want to end up missing. Okay. I'm actually going to color a little bit of this wisteria in. A couple of these. Add some of that leaf structure back. And got so stinking smooth. Okay, where was I? A little bit of tan in here too. Okay, back with the six. Okay, so this is the warm grade 4. Okay, so this is the warm gray 2. The white out and hit some. The big highlight areas. And then I can come back and start really hitting some of those darker areas and filling those out. this point, it's a game of flying back and forth. With pencils, trying to get the exact right look that I want. Starting to press in a lot of that pigment. I will admit, some of it's going to be a little hard to see. Till we really get that background in place. Because, like, here, it doesn't look like I've accomplished much. But, at the same time, you can't see it 100% because it's white and I'm coloring white on white. And so until I get that the darker part of the cottage to really define that spot, you're not going to see the shape of it.
back it up just a touch.
So on a whole, that's kind of where that's sitting. Whoop! Sorry, just dropped a pencil. I will admit that mine is taking on a slightly different artistic quality than the original. But I can't say that I truly dislike it. Those down real quick. And with that, like I said, I want to see if I can give back a little bit of that leaf-like quality. So these are just all the same purples that I used before. That way some of these branches also don't look like they're just thrown in there, floating around. Oh, goodness, I'm just flinging the tip around, pressing a little too hard. Right now, I'm just kind of playing around with what looks good. Not necessarily worrying about being 100% true. To what is going on in the actual picture. Because I'd like to think at this point, I'm kind of making it my own. Okay. I think this is where I'm gonna leave it for now. We very distinctly have a tree. I guess I could color the swing real quick because I don't think it'll take much. Sorry, my Fitbit keeps hitting the desk. I'm gonna throw in a little bit of the tan, and I'm gonna come through with a warm gray too. smooth that out a bit. Boom. There's now also a swing. Yeah. The thing is, I don't want to totally overwork it. And like I said, I might have to rework the trunk a little bit as I start getting more of the picture completed, but I think this is a good place to stop for now. I think my plan is next time that I work on the sky, because I really feel like getting that sky in, and we might work like this way down, but at the same time I might end up working the sky and then some of the plant life over here and the wall, and you know how I would do Kincaid. Just whatever is calling me at the time. So I think I'm gonna do that. Gotta so many different colors. Now, next weekend, I don't think I'm going to be having a live stream. I'm not 100% sure on that, so if you want to get the most recent update, I recommend either subscribing to my channel so you get the notification when I put out the reminder that I'll be having a live stream, or go follow me on Twitter. I always tweet out that I'm going to be doing a live through Twitter. But otherwise, if I am not here next weekend, I will definitely be back in 2 weeks. Of course, as always, same time, same place, 11 Central, my channel. Like I said, probably will be doing the sky. And I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your weekend. And I heart your beautiful faces. Bye.